So let's refactor our application now so that certain parts are more abstract. And specifically, we'll be trying to provide, to simplify how we use managers, because right now we are using reactive extensions, Eric Start, and writing a manager that interacts with endpoint, with web resources, results in the same code all over again. So we have to create those subjects and we need to hook it all together. There is a lot of boilerplate and we will be trying today to eliminate that. But before we do that, I would like to tell you that I've seen some comments that the service I created and the one I made online for contacts is now usable again. If you go to FIP, flutterandpractice.zeister.net, and you type contacts, you'll be getting this JSON. So if you are using that URL instead of creating your own backend, now it should work as before. Let's try to refactor this manager. Because when we have... So what's the reason for using managers in the first place? So let's talk about this principle. I think I mentioned that in one of the episodes called single responsibility principle. So that a module or class or function should basically have a single responsibility. So it should do just one thing. And we shouldn't try to do too many things in that particular unit of computation. We have services in our application which are responsible for connecting with an endpoint, so with using HTTP, for example, and serializing. So it seems they do two things, but that's still good enough for me. The single responsibility here is to request something from the URL and transform it into our domain model, so into our object. If we have contacts on a remote location, we want to have contact classes, contact instances in our application. This is the responsibility we are talking about, and we are just doing the request and serializing, or rather deserializing, those strings, this JSON payload into our classes. Now we have managers as well. So we, on top of contact service, for example, we have this contact manager. And this manager allows us to control how we interact with the service. There is this set of specific bugs we can avoid using manager. So by using debounce, for example, and by using switch map, we can make sure that the events, for example, if we are talking about filtering contacts, if we are sending the query, the filter query, we can be sure that the responses will arrive in the proper order. So if you'd like to learn more about those problems, I encourage you to watch this talk from 2018 at ReactiveCon by Brian Egan and Philip Hratek. And they dive into the problems we were trying to solve using this specific approach. So this is another responsibility. But now, in order to talk to our URL, so we have contacts in the future, we will have messages and then calendar. It seems that we'll be repeating the same code. So we can try to extract it, and we could try to create a manager that just knows what kind of resource it deals with, and then we can just use it without repeating all that. So let's try to do that. I will create a class called Web Resource Manager. And this class will be general. It will also be using generics, so those annotations that this class deals with a specific type. In this class, we'll get all that code we are using here, and instead of using a specific service, we will abstract that. So we will be passing service as a parameter for now. Later on, we will improve that. That's not the most pretty way of doing that. We will be just doing service browse, but we don't know the service yet, so we will create an interface for that, which in Dart is abstract class, and this will be also using generics. We will do this browse filter parameter, and this will be returning list of t. And because this is an asynchronous operation, this will be returning a future, like that. Now there is, as you can see, nothing specific except the name, which we will also change. And now this whole manager we can just extract away, because all the good practices like the bouncing and switch map are already baked into that class. We just need to pass the proper service. So I already did that behind the scenes, and I put this into Sprinkle architecture. So now we can just remove that. And if we go to our, we can remove that as well. If we go to our overseer, we could now, instead of using a contact manager, we could use web resource manager that deals with contacts. It's general web resource manager, so a manager that knows how to talk to an endpoint using a service, needs to know which service to use. So we need to pass it as a parameter. But because our service, if we go to a service, uses static methods, so to some extent it's just a namespace. The name of the class is somehow a namespace over those methods and potentially fields as well. We need to slightly improve that. So we need to make it an instance, which is a good thing, like that. So now in order to use that class, we need to create an instance of, because we can just pass the instance here. So we can say contact service instance. We are creating the instance, we are passing the instance as the first parameter. And what do we need to do? The only thing we need to do is to make sure that the interface that's being used is by the web resource manager. So the one we created here, service, we are saying use browse from service. We need to make sure that our contact service just implements that interface so that it all connects. Like that. And again, this is available in the Sprinkle. This place over here, it seems it's all okay. But now we need to somehow change the interface for the overseer. Because we are just passing this hash, it would be nice to have a way to register those relations between the type and the implementation. Right now, the types we use as keys refer to the same classes, but in future we could make it even more general by using this technique called programming to an interface, which means that it's not important how we achieve something, but it's important what we want to achieve, basically. So we have interfaces and they define the constraints on our classes, and then we just provide the concrete implementations. But for now, we will just leave it as it is, because there are other problems here, and we will, as always, we will try to resolve that one problem at a time. So in order to improve this overseer, we will implement this method which registers each specific manager inside. So we will call it register. It will be taking a type, which can be compound as well. So for example, web resource manager for contacts. And it will be taking the factory we want to register for that type. And we'll just say factories t, assign factory. And then we'll do this trick. We will do return this, so that it returns the overseer, so the already existing instance, so that we can chain those registers. So let's see that in practice. We can also remove the constructor now, because we won't be using it. We'll be registering our factories using just the register method. So here, instead of doing it like that, we will just do register here, and we will basically copy this part over here, and we will register that, and this will be web resource manager for contact, like that, something of that sort. And now we can chain, so we can, for example, say register, and we can reuse the old managers. We will change them later and do the same. So a lazy invocation like that. And finally, we can do this part over here. So we can do register message form like that. And like that. So we are just registering those managers with a very specific case here for this general manager that knows how to talk to a remote RESTful API. And that's pretty much it. So now, so we no longer need this contact manager. We can remove that. And now everywhere where we are using this old reference, we will need to convert that. Here's the same. So I'll just paste that. So there's one more thing I changed behind the scenes. So in this general manager, I changed the name from browse. It was browse before, and I changed it to collection. So I think it's a better name. I hope you don't mind. And now the web resource manager, once you provide a query to filter, will get you back a counter and a collection of the elements that it fetched. And later on, we will also implement other things so it somehow aligns with the RESTful architecture. But for now, it's okay. I just changed the name from browse to collection here. So now here we need to change it to collection as well. Here it's the same. So the same way of accessing using this general web resource manager. And again, it's not browse anymore, it's collection. So we don't need that, and we don't need that. Okay, so it seems it's okay. Let's reload, and let's see if it works. So it works, it loads, so let's see. Searching, it works. So it was a little bit of refactoring. Once again, this general web resource manager is available as a part of this plugin I'm working on, which will try to provide a convenient best practices. It's not yet perfect. There are some things we need to discuss. We need to clarify here, but I want to keep it short. So stay tuned for the next episode of Flutter in Practice.